Hey, and what is going on, everybody? Welcome to the Farm Dream. My name is Raymond, and this is the dream. A big truck is backing up right now, dropping all the wood chips. That's for today. A lot more to come. Join me. Let's start the day. So there it is. It is safe to say that this is probably enough for a long time. It's a little bit more green than I expected it to be. I thought it was only going to be wood chips. But of course, the green will decay really quickly and it will just leave the wood chips as it is. So, beautiful pile, no idea what to do with it because it's kind of in the wrong spot. Just gonna try and use a little bit now and see how it looks within the beds. Let's just start with that and then we'll move on with the day. I'm just gonna continue to work the land in a no-dig way. So we're just gonna add cardboard in this pathway, put the wood chips on top, and let's just have a look. The first wood chip path, perfect, in between two perfect beds. Really happy with this. This is a great start of the farm. We have to do some planting, but before I do that, I wanna see if I can find some material to create some hoops, to put some tarp or some fleece on top to keep the winter out, because of course we need to protect the plants a little bit. Also, I need to get a tarp for the wood chips. So let's go out and let's get some stuff. So my idea was to use this PVC pipe and just really stick it in there and work it all the way down as far as I need it, because this is actually a great height as well. So we get some crops underneath here and we'll be fine. It's quite sturdy, at least it bounces back and we can secure it a little bit more. I got a little bit of a bigger pipe as well and we can make some clamps and clamp plastic or whatever you want to clamp on there. So I think this is a great solution. And it's a cheap solution as well. One of these tubes only costs like 80 cents. So yeah, really happy with this. And the last thing for today is going to be tarping off this giant heap. I just want to protect it a little bit from the elements. Doesn't have to be too much, but a little bit of protection goes a long way. I also don't want to protect everything because my tarp isn't big enough. So yeah, we're just gonna have to do with what we have. Now a few days have gone by, but we're back at it. I'm gonna start in the front yard today because we planted some honey blueberries here. We need to take them out. And there's also some other stuff that I just wanted to show you because it is still growing here. Let's get into it. Now I just wanted to start with a quick tour of the front yard because we have been growing a lot and we're still growing a lot. It's still no frost here, so we're still good, but I just wanted to show you quickly what's going on, what's still growing. Let me start with these leaves. They've been dropping into the garden from the front yard from across the street, and it's actually free mulch, so we're just gonna drop that in there and leave it there, and it's gonna be great for winter, just slowly decaying, and we'll get some extra nutrients in. All the way in the back here, red cabbage, and it's actually been growing really well. It's the first time that I've grown it, but the results are really good. They're ready for harvest, so we're gonna do that maybe next week. I think I give them a little bit more time, but I wanna harvest them quite badly. In front of that, the beetroot, and this is like the fourth sowing of beetroot this year. They're still really small, but we're gonna just let them be, let them sit. The spring onion, it is growing, but it's also gonna be over winter. In front of that, a surprise to me. I planted these, and I recorded it actually, planted these some time back, when it was actually already too late, but they're still giving some beans. So butter beans, wax beans, however you want to call them, they're doing really well. The kale still growing, just gonna leave that in. They are sort of perennial, so they can stay in there for 2 years, let them sit, and next spring they will go crazy and grow on us. The leak is also doing great. I wish they were a little bit bigger, but it should be fine. Then next to that, the fennel, to be honest, the fennel, I don't think it's going too well. We should just harvest them, take them out. They are bolting like crazy. All the beans in front of that are doing really well. We just got some green beans, some brown beans, some French dwarf beans. They're all doing great, actually way better than expected. So that's pretty much the garden that's filled up. The other spot filled up with the salads, the rucola or the rocket, the spinach, they're slowly growing and we're hoping that we'll still see some results from that, but I'm not too sure. That's about it. Now let's get to work. We got these beautiful honey blueberries and we decided to put them in this border, three of them, but they are gonna outgrow this space next year. So instead of leaving them in, we're just gonna take them out. We are probably gonna leave those blueberries in here so we can use that for breakfast when we wake up, but these three are gonna go out. And also the eucalyptus over here, we're gonna try and take out because it's gonna grow way too big for this spot. So taking that out and bringing that all to the land. Let's go. All right, that's it, they're all out. Let's go to the farm. Back on the land, and there's actually been quite some work done. We did this at night. You can see a picture here. So we were working in the middle of the night. I used my lights of the car to light the scene. So a few things have changed. Let me show you, and then we'll get to it. The main thing that changed is that we created more beds in the flower garden. This one is now completely done. We just need to fill it with plants. We put a lot of mulch in between here. Also created that long raised bed over there for flowers. And we are changing a little bit of the view here because we're thinking another bed here instead of just one, we're gonna do two and put them close to each other. So that's gonna be great. Eucalyptus over there, probably not the final spot, but just for now. And then this large bed over here still needs more compost. We did this last night. It is looking okay, but we did make a little bit of a mistake. Put the rope in the wrong position, so it's a little bit too wide. Gonna take that back today. But that's the main changes. Also, stop tarping off this big pile because I got a notice from a friend. He said, don't tarp it off, it will catch fire. So we're just gonna let it air now and make sure that we don't get any fire in here. But it's still looking great. The green is decomposing. It's starting to look more woody. So really happy with that. And one thing that we also did was mulch up the blueberries. This was a tip by Simply Garden and Home, a great YouTube channel. I'll link it down below. Just a great family that's farming and so many tips on that channel. So be sure to look out for that. All right, let's continue with building. The honey blueberries are in and they're looking beautiful. They do look a little bit bigger than the normal blueberries, but they will probably catch up. They will, in the end, probably be a little bit bigger as well, but it's all right. We also topped it off with the wood chips. We put it in kind of a less acidic soil than we did with the normal blueberries because they don't require it. They do require some nutrients, so we added the compost in there and we also topped it off with the wood chips again. It's looking beautiful. Let's head to the eucalyptus because we need to get that one in as well. The eucalyptus is also in, also looking beautiful. Really happy with that. Next up is planting some seeds. This is for October seeding. So if you guys wanna follow along, I'm planting carrots and I'm also doing a winter salad and the garlic still needs to arrive. I ordered some bulbs, but there seems to be some shipment problems. So they're arriving later. First, carrots and winter salad. Let's go. We're gonna plant two different varieties of carrots in here. I already did the lettuce, they're at home. We're gonna let them grow a little bit underneath the grow lights. And then when they are big enough, we're gonna transplant them out here in the bed next to it. The garlic still needs to arrive, so we're waiting for that to happen. So carrots for now, two varieties, one suggested by a subscriber, so thank you for that. We're gonna try and see how that works out. We're gonna do the left bed for the carrots right now. Let's get them in there. Now, we've been trying to grow carrots quite a few times, and there's a batch that goes okay, and there's always a batch that's like crooked. They split open and you got two carrots coming from just one seed. Doesn't look that good. So suggestion by a subscriber, he said the Chantenay, it seems to be that it's a little bit of a shorter carrot and therefore it is less prone to split open because it doesn't have to go that far. The other one is still a long carrot, so we're just gonna test how the soil is right now. Let's get them in, let's create three rows, and let's see the results. The carrots are in and the fleece is on top. Can't wait till spring when they finally show up. That's a good rhyme, isn't it? Anyway, really happy with the first crops in. It's carrots. I wish it was something more than just carrots, but the rest is coming. Garlic is coming, maybe some onions, and also the lettuce are gonna go in probably next week. So if you guys enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you wanna join the adventure, subscribe, and don't forget to live the farm dream.